You are well aware about the policy of the TRS-led government in Telangana, because in 2014, when we went to people for election, for mandate, this is the only party in the country which included the direct selling business in its manifesto. We assured the people. On that day, it has not happened just like that. So I took a lot of pain to convince our Honorable Chief Minister, at the time he was the President of the party, to convince him and to convince the panel who are responsible for drafting of manifesto. There are so many IAS officers, former secretaries. So it took, I think, 2 to 3 hours to convince all of them why we should include the direct selling in this manifesto. So I explained the potentiality of the direct selling and the intention of the direct sellers. So finally, our Chief Minister understood. Even now also is with good opinion about direct selling and about the companies and the products. Sometime back, he has himself used the products. So let me share a few things. Even just now, our speakers said the Telangana is the first government which implemented the guidelines. It was happened when the summit was took place, World Economic Summit. At that time, one company, global CEO, and few others came along with our IDSA vice chairman, Ajit Energy. And I played a great role in that also. I represented direct selling companies on that day, though I am in the government. The opposite side, our Honorable Minister for Industries and J.S. Ranjanji, Secretary, and others are represented government. I sat along with the IDSA Vice Chairman. So, finally we convinced and we explained about the guidelines, the importance of implementing the guidelines in Telangana. So thanks to Rajatji for his effort as the IDSA Vice Chairman on that day. Just after 2 or 3 days, the government has decided to permit the IDSA companies to follow the guidelines in this state. So why I said this is the right time to take off? Because to understand that, first we need to understand why this direct selling emerged in this world. So long back, it's 100 years ago, I hope it is in 1910, first direct selling association started in USA on different name, but finally the intention was direct selling, but name was different. I will take that name because the founding member was Avon. The later, many companies came up, and now more than 130 companies in the DSA, Direct Selling Association of Global, particularly in USA. And here also many companies are there in direct selling. First, I understood what is direct selling. Here, everyone who want to sell the products in the direct selling company, they need skills. They need ethics. And just now, sir said relationship. We cannot sell just with relationship, because they are also doing relationship. Some companies are under the garb of direct selling. They are cheating the people with relationship only. So no doubt relationship should have, but just I will add one thing, sir. Mentorship. Relationship as well as mentorship. Because customers, they don't know which product is good and which product is bad for their health or for their livelihood. They are not experts of analyzing the products. Whatever the product you take to them, they are not the experts. They should believe Aishwarya Rai or Sachin Tendulkar, or they should believe the person who bought that product to them. Here the skill is required, because we can sell any product, even poison also, by showing the face of some actor, actress. People love to take it because their favorite actor introduced that. They will take, they are taking the poison also on different names, slow poisons. But only the direct seller will add the value to the product through his knowledge. That was the purpose of direct selling. Because when Carl Reinborg introduced the multivitamin tablet, alfalfa, in 1934, why he followed the direct selling, we should understand. Because just he cannot sell that product like a medicine. The customer should know what are the ingredients, how they will help to his health. Whatever the personal care product or home care product, any product, there is a difference between the market products and direct selling companies' products. That difference the customer should understand. That's why the direct seller, he cannot sell the product without adding the value to the product and without telling the knowledge about that product to the customer. So he has to take lot of pain, lot of time he has to spend in building relationship, in giving mentorship and the exchange of knowledge. So that's why direct selling companies, we have to go to the roots why this industry is emerging and how this industry will go forward. If you understand in right way the direct selling, no doubt in coming days this will become the number one business in consumer market anywhere in the world, not only in India. But you have more opportunities in India because here political situation or the policy makers' thoughts are encouraging us. Some good news to direct selling industry, some bad news to the society. Because all these governments are depending mainly on the excise revenue. They want to increase the excise revenue. They want to open more shops, more wine shops, more liquor shops. So bad news to the society. But good news is they can get relief after consuming the alcohol only through supplements. Many people came to me because my video in which I have taken the name of direct selling company and also direct selling business and some products. So after it went viral, maybe some crores of people, millions of people shared that video to many lakhs of people. So in the after that video, I got almost every day 50 to 60 calls regarding direct selling and also products. See, ladies, you know many women participating in the direct selling industry. Just they will ask like this, my husband is addicted to drink. What can I do? How can it stop? Then I suggest them to take him to Narketpally, where the de-addiction center is there. So no sir, he can't come. Then you use supplement. At least his survival time will be more. There are some supplements. You can approach the direct sellers. They will provide the supplement. At least some relief. Otherwise, he will die. And some cases, yesterday, one lady who worked in one direct selling company in Hyderabad, she got cancer. First, when she know about the cancer, breast cancer, it was very easy to control it through supplements, through increasing the immunity in her body. See, there are two types of treatments are handling the challenges, health challenges. One is suppressing that by using chemicals, synthetic chemicals. Second is curing that by improving the immunity. So always we have to prefer the improve immunity. But in practice, many hospitals and doctors, they are treating the patient, but they don't say about cure. They will say treating. That will goes on continuously until her last breath. So after surgery to her breast, it has spread to all over the body. No organ is spared now. But still she is surviving only on supplements. Only on supplements. Doctors already raised their hands 1 month ago. They said you will die. But she is surviving. I know what are the supplements she is using. She is getting from abroad also some supplements and getting some supplements from here. But I can say all the supplements which are good to health, she is using only from direct selling industries, only from IDSA members. Sir, to conclude, because I have taken a lot of time, I wanted to share so many things. This government is with you, no doubt, because Chief Minister understood about this direct selling industry and about the quality of the products. And many people here, one good thing is government is unable to providing jobs to millions of unemployed youth. See, in any country, in any state, only 1% people of that motherland, of that state, can get government jobs. But remaining 99, government cannot pay salaries to them. So already here, 1% is 3.5 lakhs, but we have created 4.5 lakh jobs. I'm sure in next 10 years, these unemployed youth can get opportunity in any business or any other areas, not in the government or in the private sector, because in private sector also, it can provide only 4 lakhs to 5 lakhs unemployed youth every year. But here, there are 9 to 10 lakhs graduates and unemployed youth joining in the list every year. They cannot get jobs. More than 50% of the educated youth, they are roaming on the roads for searching opportunities. So this is the best time to convince them, to bring them into the direct selling industry for the sake of human health and well-being of the society. So with these words, I am concluding, and thanks for inviting me as a guest. And I wish you all the best for in building direct selling business and in convincing the officials as well as people, and in following the ethics and rules of guidelines. Thank you.